Welcome to CRISIL TV. CRISIL today released a report titled Choosing Trend Over Cycle, which looks at the performance of the Modi government and concludes that over the last 2 years, the steps that have been taken will do more to push the trend rate of growth than to support the cyclical growth in the economy. To put it in context, governments have an option of either pushing the cyclical growth up through aggressive monetary and fiscal policies, or they can choose to do structural reforms which have an impact on the economy with a lag and are difficult to push at times. I think the steps taken by the Modi government over the last 2 years are more focused on raising the trend or the potential rate of growth. Now, there are two dimensions of India growth story that we have focused on in this report. The number one dimension relates to the quality of growth in India. The second relates to the potential disruption that can happen from the technology sector. So why is the quality of growth improving? We believe that the quality of growth is improving because of three factors. Number one is monetary and fiscal policies. They aren't aggressive like they were in 2009 to 2011, when they did push the growth up, but also created inflation and fiscal pressures. And eventually the growth could not be sustained. But this time around, both the monetary and fiscal policies are pretty prudent. As far as the fiscal policy is concerned, the deficit has been budgeted to come down. The quality of spending is improving with its focus on infrastructure. And as far as monetary policy is concerned, we have a framework in place which looks at explicit inflation targeting, which also looks at creating a monetary policy committee, which will have a more participative process in monetary decision making. So overall, I think we are creating conditions for lower fiscal deficit and a stable inflation regime going ahead. Food inflation is a bugbear for us though. Government in the last 2 years, despite drought, managed to control food inflation through some tactical measures. But I think eventually we need reforms in the agriculture sector to raise productivity so that there is a permanent lid on food inflation going ahead. The second factor why we believe that the quality of growth is improving is that it's not fired by credit creation. If you look at China today, it is supporting its growth through excessive credit creation, which creates its own risk. I think in India, if you look at the credit creation, it has trailed the overall nominal GDP growth rate. So I think we are fine on that front as well. And finally, the growth has been accompanied by a mix of repair and reforms. There have been attempts to clean up the power sector, to clean up the banking sector. This is all work in progress, but the beginning has been made. The government has also managed to pass two critical bills. One of them is the Aadhaar bill, which allows distribution of subsidies, wages, etc. through the electronic platform. And the second is the bankruptcy code, which will allow resolution of bankruptcies with least pain to all the stakeholders. And then there is the digitalization upside. The Modi government has been quick to board the technology bandwagon and has initiated steps to improve financial inclusion as well as delivery of government services using the technology platform. Now, unlike the economic reforms which have a linear impact on the economy, the technology-related reforms can have a non-linear or a disruptive impact. When it will play out is hard to say, and at times the impact of technology is also unimaginable, but I think it can definitely give a lot of boost to efficiency because agents across the economy will be saving time, they will be saving energies and will become more efficient. So you'll be able to produce more with less. We had seen this kind of efficiency pick up during 2004 to 2008 when computerization, telecom, they created a lot of efficiency gains and increased the total factor productivity growth in India. Clearly, digitalization has the potential to create an efficiency-led spurt in growth. But for that, we also have to ensure that there is electricity across the board available to everyone, and also ensure that there is internet connectivity. These are the two areas in which we are laggards. But to run a growth marathon, apart from continuing with the existing reforms, apart from the digitalization upside, we also need to focus on health, education, and physical infrastructure. Only then India will be able to run a growth marathon.